So you have a Basler GigE camera, and it doesn't seem to be working. Or at least you cannot see it in Pylon Viewer. Let's run through some of the basic troubleshooting processes to see if we can figure out what is going on. First, make sure the camera is plugged into a source that is providing power. That can either be power over Ethernet, a PoE injector, or power via the 6-pin Hiroshi connector. An easy way to know if your camera is getting power is to touch it. After a few minutes of being plugged in, the camera should feel warm. Now, in Pylon Viewer, look to the device pane. Here you should see a list of all interfaces that have drivers installed. For a GigE camera, you should have GigE listed here. If you do not, you will need to reinstall Pylon Viewer, making sure you select to install all of the GigE drivers. Next, in the toolbar, under Tools, there'll be a selection for IP Configurator. In this window, you will see all of the ways your PC can communicate with the network. If no cameras are listed, then most likely you have a firewall or company security policy enabled that is blocking all unrecognized network communications. You'll need to disable your firewall or set permissions for this device in particular. For testing purposes, disable your firewall and turn off the security policy. Now you should see some cameras. Now look to the status bar. We can see on this network that one camera is okay, two are in use, and one is not reachable. Okay means that the camera is ready to make a connection. In use means someone is already connected to this camera and therefore we'd be unable to connect to it. Sometimes this can also be the case if your code you were running did not exit properly and the camera still thinks it's being used. You can address this by power cycling the camera and by setting a heartbeat timeout in your code. Now, when the camera does not receive a communication, it knows to release itself from its previous process. Not reachable typically happens when the camera has a static IP address set outside of the network. There are two ways to fix this. One way is to set the IP address manually. You'll need to make sure to keep the IP address within your subnet mask. You can also simply select DHCP. The camera will then take on whatever address is next available on your network when it gets connected. Now back to the device panel in Pylon Viewer. You should see the cameras and be able to connect to them either by double-clicking or by selecting the connect button.